Jake. Jake, come on in here. Go ahead and close that door. You're getting started tonight.
Thanks, Coach.
Well, you earned it. I know seeing me on the first day of practice wasn't easy.
Can't lie, it was a bit of a surprise.
I bet. You know, I started coaching because of kids like you. Kids who truly believe in the concept of team, who put others above themselves. I wasn't trying to punish you. Fact is, I respected what you did for Porter. The fact that I couldn't do it myself, the fact that I succumbed to the power, to the pressure of my job, that made me ill. I want you to know that I was an ass to resign. I chose to. That team is lucky to have you, boy. Now I want you to do me a favor.
What's that?
I want you to get out there and get us this dub.
I got you, Coach.
Here we get, Coach.
Story during this summer league, and he'll be one to watch in what should be a great championship matchup.
Well, the leadership of Che has been on display here during this tournament. He's been a big factor for the team.
Well, Che has been a leader in college, and that's an intangible that carries over into the NBA. And spending 4 years at Bay City has given him experience beyond the hardwood.
Great pass that set us a land.
He had his head on a swivel and was able to pick out the pass and get the assist.
Walden with it. Rebounded by the Warriors.
Nice work there to contest the finish inside.
Yeah, they got the shot they wanted, but his defense laid waste to those plans.
Here's Ashley, pass to Grantham. Evans, six to shoot. Shot on the wing, off to a good start as he hits his first shot at him. Here's Cheely. Some tough offensive sets, and they really want to turn it around.
They got a lot and need a basket just to regain some momentum.
Alden,
it's so hard to contain him. He gets it done however he has to do it.
Well, although summer league started rough for Che, he seems to have really found his groove.
Here's Ashley, and the Warriors pack on two more.
How's that for a move? This crossover, it's a thing of beauty.
Pass to Cheely. Now about 2 minutes gone by in the first quarter. Back kick out to Walden. Fires the three, and another three for Minnesota.
Nice pass. He got that ball right into his teammate's shooting pocket.
Yeah, after the reports that he and Coach Ames have buried the issues they've had in the past, he's been a large part of that team.
And it's an issue that both Ames and Che needed to come together on. And, you know, NBA teams don't have much patience for divides like that, so I'm glad they moved on.
foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so we'll shoot two here.
And it's going to be on Shea.
You don't want to get in the habit of letting the offense get right to the rim.
And that's the message they were sending with that foul, saying nothing easy inside with that one.
Yeah, but they got to play a little bit better defense before they get inside.
Here's Grantham. On the wing, Shea.
Let's it go!
No good on the shot. A bit long that time.
And it was only recently that the NBA decided to switch to a tournament format at the end of the league.
That one goes in.
Great job to hit his teammate on the move.
Golden State trailing. Pass to Lee. Off with the layup. It just makes so much sense. The fans love it. It adds to the competitiveness of the event. It's just a great addition.
Honestly, it's hard to imagine Summer League without the tournament now. It makes for a great finale.
Now here's Culver. He's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. Inside.
And Axel Walden slams it in. The one-hand slam just looks so pretty, and it's his hand doing the slam.
Man, he is smooth as silk, even on the power finish.
Just so pretty.
That's part of what makes him unique, that combination of the P&P, power and polish.
So he makes one of two as the second one misses. And even three-on-three break. Cool. He's guarded by Lee.
And we look at both these teams. Clearly have had some great showings so far in summer league.
They both followed the same sort of path. Slow starts at first, but once the rookies got going, they have been on a roll throughout the elimination phase.
Here's Duvall. And it's out of bounds to the Timberwolves as Minnesota leads possession. And here is Lee, looking for his first basket still in this one. Jay, right side. Out to the right wing. Shot clock at 6. Fires from 18. The Warriors again can't hit.
No getting around the fact that that's a shot he has to knock down.
The offensive rebound. Here's Bates Diop. Jay grabs the miss. And now about 3 minutes gone in the second quarter of basketball. And he drops in the layup off glass.
Man, their offense has really cranked up in the second quarter.
Jeez, that field goal percentage is now in the 60s. It's tough to beat them when they shoot it like that.
Well, seeing them now on the floor, Shea and AW were actually workout partners before the NBA draft. Two friends on opposite teams here.
And as friendly as they might be off the floor, I bet they're going to try and slaughter the other on the stat sheet. Each player looking to make a name for themselves in this championship game.
Pass to Culver. To the inside. Bell.
And he goes strong with the one-handed jam. Wonderful recognition from Jarrett Culver. Terrific at realizing when the defense has left someone open.
Now here's Lee. Tight defense on him. And now the Timberwolves on the break. And the basket by Culver.
Shooting off the catch is about confidence there. Culver's demonstrating how it's done.
Lee outside. Evans, pass to Che. Puts one up from 19, and the Warriors back on two more.
He's picked it up since the start of the second. His shots are starting to fall.
Walden. He's got 9. The baseline, Jay, off the mark. And since Che has been getting regular run with this team, they've been very hot.
The whole team just flipped a switch with him, and they've been a powerhouse in the league ever since he's gotten more minutes.
Now here's Lee, quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points in the game. Now Culver. The shot, no good.
Excellent interior D right there to force the miss.
Yeah, his defensive ability is a huge factor, no doubt about it.
Prevent those easy ones.
And we've reached halftime in this one. Warriors ahead, leading by 14. And time now for the halftime break, with the third quarter soon to follow on 2K Sports. Going just about year-round.
And one of the challenges in a summer league setting like this is gelling with your teammates. Most of these guys are playing with one another for the very first time.
It can lead to some misuse, but at the end of the day, it's basketball. We've all played pickup at the park. It's nothing these players are unaccustomed to. A 1-2 punch right there. Nice steal and some elevation on the game.
Yeah, nothing spurs some quick offense like a great play on defense.
An easy basket, too.
Man, my old coaches would be so proud. I mean, that's the importance of great on-the-ball defense being showcased there.
Well, here we are in the title game. Teams say this tournament is all about development. But when you have a chance to win it all, you take it.
You gotta give them credit for the job they've done on the boards.
Well, guys, they've done a lot of things well, but their rebounding is right at the top of the list. It's been an excellent performance from the field for him.
And winning in the summer league might not mean as much, but it does set a good culture for the team.
Oh, absolutely. And you want to have your young guys play with the expectation that winning matters. And I see both of these teams going as hard as they can.
And they're making this a runaway.
Yeah, the only question here for us to follow is how big the lead will eventually become.
He got the pass in full stride on his way to the big slam.
He was screwed up by the nice screen he ran his man into.
And then it was all acceleration to the bucket after that.
A lot of horsepower.
Some serious voltage right there, guys. Almost a backboard breaker.
Hooks up the tray. Reed can't hit. Well, one thing with Summer League, here in the championship game, you get to see rookies and sophomores take on a bigger role.
Well, most of these guys aren't going to get nearly as many shots or touches in the regular season, but they can learn to lead and put these teams on their shoulders here in a game like this.
That's good, by Colson.
It seems that every pass they make is leading to a score here. Just phenomenal ball movement.
Everyone's looking for the best shot, and it's paid off during this run.
Here's Chile, pass to Poole. Here's Chile, down low, Reed. No good, had a chance to end the run there. Here's Ashley. Yep, that one goes.
5 straight now, coming out of halftime, rolling.
Man, they've been looking out of sync offensively.
They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
Here's Poole, and he was fouled on the way up. 2 free throws for him. First trip to the free throw line for him in this one.
Take a break. 2 shots.
Was a lottery pick and Che wasn't. J Che has taken it to AW in this one.
Che is playing like he's got a chip, a big one, on his shoulder. He feels he's every bit as good as AW and is trying to make a point on the scoreboard.
And Golden State has possession. Pass to Magira.
6 feet out.
And Che with a nice bucket inside.
Every time they get scored on during this run, it seems like it's come from inside the paint. Buckle up on defense.
Yeah, it's time to collapse down and make them shoot jumpers.
Here's Poole. Here's Martin. He's guarded by Lee. Here's the ball. And the Timberwolves miss again.
If he thinks that's within his range, I've got some bad news for him.
It's impossible to say what he was thinking.
Here's Makira. They lead by 24, their biggest margin. Six on the shot clock.
Again, Golden State. He's been one of their more reliable options today. His shooting has led him to this lead.
Pass to Reed. Here's Martin. Here's Duvall. And he uses the glass on the layup. And every summer league, there are always a few surprises that surpass all expectations.
It's part of the fun, really, watching a player who nobody expected much of just explode onto the scene. Seems to happen every year.
Jumps up. The coach says, both done.
They didn't even try to get back on the break.
Wouldn't have mattered even if they did. There's no way anyone was beating him to the bucket right there.
Now here's Lee. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for him. Che, left side. Fires from the wing.
Again, Golden State.
He's just tearing it up this quarter. That lead's not going anywhere while he's this hot.
Pass to Reed. To the middle. The ball softly drops in the floater.
That's a precision shot. No room for error on the floater.
One item that stood out is their ball movement.
Things are definitely clicking. More importantly, it's tough to defend.
Jay, high post. Fires from the line. That one falls.
Well, we know how many inches he had over his man there, so it's good decision to rise up and take the jumper.
Shot from the wing. That one misses. Would have counted had it gone. At the end of the third quarter, a huge lead, and this one may already have been decided. Warriors ahead, running away with it. And we're coming right back. Be sure to stay with us as we get set for the fourth quarter. And we return to Summer League basketball here in the fourth quarter. Great to have you with us. It's been a good one. AW on the wing. And a kind roll that time on the rim as that one falls in. Pass to Evans. To the paint. Here's Pascal. By Bell.
A terrific defense at the rim. Got right in his path.
And you know they'll be worrying about him next time they take it inside, too. That's what great defenders will do to you.
Culver with the ball. Here's Bates Diop, covered by Evans. From the baseline, Bates with the block. And they'll keep possession. And Bell gets it to go.
I really like their activity in the post today. Their movement down low has just been great.
Exactly. They've generated easy opportunities inside.
Pass to Che. And they double up Che. Clock at six to the inside. The lead pass was put in just the right spot to produce the layup. Now the Timberwolves with it. Outside Walden. Final quarter here, and we're just over a minute and a half through it. Inside. to Walden.
From deep three-point range,
but they recover it. Good D by Che. Man, they're in complete control.
Everything they're doing, it's been working out. Wow.
Right wing. Baseline jumper. It's hauled in by AW.
Great look. Disappointing miss.
What happened there? I mean, that shot's almost as good as automatic.
I don't know. Check out the bounce.
That's a lot of bounce per ounce right there.
How much? What's the bounce per ounce like ratio?
I'm not sure.
BPO, bounce per ounce. An unusual stat, but look, he said it. He's a highlight reel waiting to happen.
Shane, one shot.
Just under 2.5 minutes gone by now in the final quarter. Pass to Bates Diop. Walden. There's the lob to the hoop.
The pass there floated up to the precise spot it needs to be.
And no messing around on that one. He powered it through.
Watch out.
That's an alley-oop we'll be seeing on the highlights for a few days. You know what? Scratch that. A few weeks. You know what? Scratch that. A few months.
Both Che and AW have been fantastic so far in this one, trading blows back and forth.
Well, they worked out, and they know the intensity they both bring to the game. It's a great showcase for the skills of both of these young rookies.
Good on the shot.
He's got a lot of firepower right now. What a pass he's having.
So it's the Timberwolves now. Here's Okogie.
Blanketed by the deeper in for the layup.
Here's Ashley. Here in the fourth quarter, just under 2.5 minutes gone by. And there's the foul. It'll go on Bell. That was his second foul of the game.
Tough break to the D. Took the hit and drew the whistle.
But he was late to get there. The referee couldn't give him a free pass on that one.
That just stinks. He's going to wake up sore, and it was still a foul.
Summer League.